Hey guys, and welcome to another episode of Fourth Take, where we show you the take you weren't supposed to see. I'm Mayra Castaneda, and I'm back in studio, but Chris recently went to the Yost Theater and caught up with Kevin Federline, Just Incredible, and DJ Prophet. Take a look.
Hey guys, I'm here with Fourth Take on location at the Yost Theater. Tonight we're hitting up Club Lit with Kevin Federline, DJ Prophet, and Just Incredible. It's gonna be an awesome night. Here's my friend Jerry. We're gonna come over to him and just say hey. He's gonna let us know what's going on. How are you going, Jerry?
Hey, how you doing?
Yeah, nice to be here.
All right.
So tell us a little bit about what you do.
Well, basically what I do is, I'm with Jubico Entertainment, and what we are is we're the entertainment division of AES Marketing. And what I do is anything music, anything concerts, stuff like that, club events, like we put it together.
You're the guy to know then.
Yeah, something like that.
Great, hey, exactly. Hey. Let's go inside, see what's happening. Hey guys, I'm behind the scenes here at the Yost. We've got Kevin Federline and DJ Prophet setting up. Let's go see them do their sound check. Prophet.
Yes, sir.
Thank you for being on Fourth Take. How's it going?
Excellent. Thanks for having me.
Yeah. Are you tired?
Nah.
I hear you guys are partying up in Vegas last night.
Oh, these guys were, man. I'm actually coming out from Hollywood just today, so I actually caught a break, got some sleep last night, and I'm ready to go.
Yeah, you ready? You got your set lined up?
Nope. I just kind of make it up as I go. You know, I'm playing the early set, so people are just coming in. So I'm just trying to set the vibe right, you know, make sure I don't play all the hits before these guys get on and, you know, burn them. But I'm going to do my thing, definitely entertain whoever's here. And as we build up, it'll be perfect timing for what I'm playing.
Awesome. And, I mean, how's your journey been in the industry?
Oh, man, it's been awesome. I mean, I started 17 years ago, and through the time and work that I put in, I've been able to meet all my my hip-hop idols and musical idols are the records I used to be buying. Now I've toured with some of my favorites, The Far Side and Big Get from Goody Mob, and you know, all these 90s. I've worked with Be Real from Cypress Hill, and gotten to meet some of my DJ idols, DJ Premier and Mixmaster Mike, and it's been awesome, you know, just plugging away and staying with it, and it's all worked out to everything I ever dreamed of. I've pretty much done.
So this whirlwind roller coaster.
Yeah, it's been great. It's been great.
So what's next for you?
Man, next, just working with Kevin. We're just booking, you know, spot date shows, and we got the Goody Mob World Tour coming up. They have the 20-year reunion of Soul Food, the 20-year anniversary next year of Soul Food, since that album dropped. And so we're gonna be doing a tour with CeeLo and Gip and the rest of the guys from Goody Mob. And then just doing my weeklies, man, I have in LA, and guest spots, traveling wherever, you know, they want to hear my sound. And turn it up.
Awesome. Well, thank you so much.
Thank you, man.
Looking forward to seeing the show tonight.
No doubt. It's going to be a good one.
It'll be awesome. Check him out, guys.
Let's go. DJ Prophet. Check me out. DJProphet.com. DJProphet. Do it. Come on, guys. We're going to see the behind-the-scenes stuff that no one else sees. Shh. Come on. Fourth Take.
Hey guys, I'm third wheeling here on the DJ stand with K-Fed, DJ Prophet, getting a little bit of an insight into what goes on behind the scenes before a big show like this, so check it out.
Very good.
Here we go, little long ago, when you walk on the sidewalk.
Hey, check out this microphone.
Focus, fire,
smooth. The effects are in order. To be here right now with Kevin Federline. Kevin, how's it going?
Good, man. Good. Really good.
Thank you very much for being on the show.
No problem.
So let us know, what's your set like for tonight?
Oh, gosh. My set, I play open format, so it's all over the place. I'm heavy. I'm really into like the trap, dubstep trap music right now. But I come from hip-hop background, so there's definitely that. And I love playing the hits. So I kind of mix as much of it in as I possibly can in an hour and a half.
So I mean, right now, like, you don't know exactly what you're going to play. You just
Well, when I first started out, man, I had my playlist set, and I mean, I stuck to it, and that was what you got, you know. But now, as time goes on, you learn how to read a room, and yeah, exactly. So I mean, I'll put together, like, I'll know like the first five or six songs that I'm going to start with, and it kind of gives me a judgment on how it could go, how it's going to go with the crowd. From there, I just take it to
yeah. And I mean, it must be a bit of a rush, like being up there, all those people coming to see you essentially.
Dude, it is. You know, it's funny because I mean, obviously I come from like a performance background, so I'm very used to being on stage. I'm very used to being on TV. I thought he was there. You know, and it always was a rush, just getting up in front of that many people and performing, even though you have the dance steps down or you're, you know, you have it down. I mean, there's always a chance you can mess up. But I mean, that's what I love about, you know, being a DJ is not about being perfect to me. I think a lot of people nowadays, everybody wants to be perfect. They got everything all synced up and it's like, I should have 100% set. Hey, if I mess up, cool. You probably won't notice it, so yeah. it doesn't matter.
Exactly, right? So I mean, I hear last night you were in Vegas.
Yes.
Tonight you're here in LA. And so you're heading to Japan soon? Is that the plan?
Yeah, I'm going to Japan in October, going to Tokyo. It's my first time. I've been around the world like three times and I've never been to any Asian country.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, so I'm so excited to go there. I'll be there from the 21st of October until the 28th.
Well, good luck. Have a safe flight if I don't see you beforehand.
Yeah, it'll be pretty wild.
Yeah, so I mean, after Japan.
They already started drinking.
What's next for you?
After that, I think I'll be in Chicago. I'm going to Portland in a couple of weeks. You know, it's starting to build, you know, it's a slow build, but it's perfect for me because, you know, I need the time to prepare for each show. So.
Yeah, that recovery right after.
Right.
You're not on until midnight tonight. What time can you finish up?
Oh, I don't know. I probably won't even. I'll probably go on at like 12:30 and be done at 2, unless they want to keep this place open until 5 a.m., you know. Break a couple of California's laws, who cares? Water and Red Bull, that's right.
Well, I mean, well, good luck tonight. Hey, really man,
thank you so much.
Show. And,
perfect.
Thanks for being
I'll
on
look you up
today.
Next time I'm in Oz.
Yeah, for sure.
Cool, man. Pleasure.
Catch ya.
Go Prime TV!
Okay, I'm the one she wear.
I'm thinking about the legs on his dick like a fresh right leg.
It was such a successful night. I'm here with Mash and Pete Wilson. Thank you so much, guys, for having us. It's been a blast.
Thanks for having us, man. Appreciate you coming by.
Yeah, appreciate you, man.
Guys, such a successful night. Holy crap, we had some fun. Guys, how are you going? I mean, you guys put so much work in tonight. Obviously, it paid off. Everyone enjoyed themselves. How are you feeling right now?
Feeling pretty good.
Amazing. Okay.
Amazing. These guys have been working effortlessly for this for so long.
Especially this guy. He's been double timing.
He's all behind the scenes.
He's a recording artist too.
Yeah.
Pete Wilson. So all while working on his project, his music project, we've been putting this together too. This whole event. So like, this guy's been working hard.
This is the stuff we don't see. This is why Fourth Take is here, to show you these guys that, you know, the stuff you don't get to see, guys, that's what we do. So glad to meet you. You guys have got so much coming up as well. Tell us a bit about that. Like, Fourth Take is going to be there, hopefully, to see all of what do you got planned next.
Oh, for sure. You guys are invited to anything we got going on. Appreciate you guys coming out. And basically, what we got coming up, this is just a stepping stone. You know, we're just going to continue to build and grow. And I hope you guys grow with us.
Definitely. Same here. We appreciate so much the invite. And guys, make sure you keep watching Fourth Take, because we're going to hook up with these guys some more. And you know, you're in for a massive roller coaster, and I'm just so excited to be part of it. Thanks.
That's what's up. Look out for Jubico Entertainment. Look out for our recording artist, Pete Wilson. And we're going to keep trying to bring you the best events and projects that we can.
Yeah, guys, Joey and Pete, there's some awesome guys. Make sure you just follow everyone here. Thanks a lot.
I'm so bummed I missed out, but Chris, next time you're in studio and I'm on location. Well, moving on to movie buzz, it was a very busy week. While promoting his new film, The Martian, which is out in theaters now, Ridley Scott leaked some very important information to his fans. Scott hinted that the first of three sequels to his 2012 film, Prometheus, will be called, drumroll please, Alien Paradise Lost. Now, the filming will take place next year, early in the year. Now, The Walking Dead is set to return to TV this October, but if you were anything like me, you got your zombie fix through Fear the Walking Dead. That's the 6-episode series that premiered this summer. Now, it's supposed to give the audience a first-hand look at how things were in LA before the outbreak took over mankind. Now, it did take me a couple of episodes to really get into it. It started off slow, but let me tell you, it finishes off with a bang. Now, if you are a Walking Dead fan, I definitely encourage you to watch this because it does kind of answer some of the questions us Walking Dead fans had before the season started. Now, even though the series finale already aired, I feel like zombies is the gift that keeps on giving because Fear the Walking Dead was renewed for a second season. But not only that, it also has a companion web series, which will be called Fear the Walking Dead Flight 462. Now, this follows a group of passengers on a commercial flight during the birth of the outbreak. So I can just imagine all the bad things that can happen during that flight. The story will be told in a span of 16 webisodes, all a minute or less. And moving on to hammers and long hair, Thor fans, we have some exciting news for you. Thor Ragnarok has possibly found its new director, Taika Waititi. I hope I'm saying his name correctly. Well, he hails from New Zealand, and the script was written by Christopher Yost and Craig Kyle. You guys are gonna have to wait just a little bit longer for that. It's supposed to hit theaters November 2017. And in your Netflix roundup, new this month for October is one of my favorite shows starring my girl, Gina Rodriguez, with Jane the Virgin. Also new this month is American Horror Story Freak Show, The Flash Season 1, and Arrow Season 3. Now, moving on to movies, this is definitely, you guys, a 90s classic. American Pie, also new this month, is Batman Begins, The Curse of Chucky, and Million Dollar Baby. Now, that concludes your Netflix roundup. Finally today, since it is October, we want to get into the Halloween spirit. We have a behind-the-scenes look of Jack Black's new movie, Goosebumps. Let's watch.
Hi. It's me, Jack Black, on the set of Goosebumps. I'm playing R.L. Stein, and I have to whisper because they're shooting a scene right now. It's very exciting. Got a tremendous cast, amazing crew. Think it's gonna be a good one.
I think it really is important and nostalgic, and I'm really excited that we get to bring it back and remind people of it and also introduce people to it with the movie.
Security cap.
The experience has been incredible. It's exciting to cater to such a huge audience.
These are all Goosebumps manuscripts. Why are these books locked?
What we wanted to do with the film was to take what was essential about Goosebumps and then make that bigger.
Some of the most amazing big action set pieces combined into a movie for everybody.
It's a very high-level group of people with incredible talent that makes the movie feel even bigger.
I'm just so thrilled that this Goosebumps movie will be around forever. What a wonderful thing to see your work capped off by this great film.
I think it's gonna be a very entertaining movie that I don't think will ever get old.
Everyone loves Goosebumps.
And that wraps up this episode of Fourth Take. Make sure to find us on Facebook and Instagram and subscribe to us on YouTube. I'm Mayra Castaneda, and I'll see you next week.
From
the top? This is the last one. Last take, guys.
Oh, I'm fine.
Let's get this.
Last take. Let's make it happen.
Let's change the show to last take.
Last take. Last take. All right.